Commander, I've got Admiral Anderson on the QEC. Patching him through to you now.
Shepard.
Admiral, how you holding up?
Day by day, Commander.
Yeah. Hackett sent me a message about this apartment.
I want you to have it. Take it off my hands.
Are you serious?
You need a place that's yours. Somewhere to recharge. Clear your head. Kaylee wanted us to settle down there. Thing is, the longer I'm on Earth, the less I want to leave. And I want as few loose ends out there as possible. Like I said, you'd be doing me a favor.
It's too generous. Besides, you'll be back here once the war's over.
I doubt it. Even assuming we survive this, it'll take years to rebuild things here. Please, Commander. Don't make me beg.
All right. Consider it done.
I appreciate it. And make yourself at home, damn it. It's yours now.
I'm sure I can manage.
Okay, good. Been meaning to do that for a while. I'll talk to you soon.
So long, Admiral.
Anderson out. You never asked me about this, but my wife just called. My ex-wife. Nobody likes to talk about the toll that long months apart can have on military relationships. She wasn't military.
You have she couldn't handle message. It.
But it's not even about military and non-military, dammit. It's spaceflight. Spaceflight. Finding the mass relays, miracles of engineering. Human imagination rising to meet our desires. We pay a price for that curiosity, that drive. Our relationships suffer. People we love suffer. But that's reality. And it's worth the cost. I must have thought it was. I guess I still do. In the end, you just have to hope you made the right choices. The Normandy? A brand new ship. My ship. You don't forget that moment. The first time you're standing there. The whole crew looking to you for direction. Unforgettable. I'd led men and women before that. Seen a lot of combat already. Always managed to find my way home in one piece. Do that a few times, you begin to think you know better than the next guy. Maybe you do, I don't know. But if you're lucky, really lucky, you find yourself on a good ship, in front of a good crew. A crew you can trust with your life. Gifted. Disciplined. Brave. All of them, eager to set sail into the endless black ocean. I still remember my XO asking what my orders were. Shepard, I said, let's see what we can find.
I had met my first
learned an important lesson that day. No matter how good you think you are, there's always somebody quicker, faster, and a hell of a lot smarter than you just around the corner. That little lesson's kept me alive more than once since then. Sure, I can talk about Commander Shepard. Deep topic. There's been a lot written about the Commander, but most of it isn't true. People are quick to judge. They don't know the whole story. I don't even know the whole story. But I know the woman. Worked with her. Fought with her. Trust her with my life. Shepard's had some rough patches. Who of us hasn't? She's been forced to fight a lot of battles alone. God only knows how she got out of some of that. Makes your head spin. Thing is, you never heard a complaint. Never once got, "No, sir, I can't do that." She never hesitated. Few people know what Shepard's been through. I'd like to think I come pretty close. And I worry sometimes she forgets. There's a whole bunch of people who lose sleep over her getting back home. Maybe it doesn't need to be said. Maybe we're too dumb to say it. Soldiers like the Commander are rare. Women like Shepard, even more rare. No, no, it's fine. I got a few minutes. First contact war? Yeah. I was there. My first real combat. First for a lot of us. I remember one night early in the war, strapped to my seat as our transport approached the LZ. Everyone was dead silent. Just the sound of breathing. Good men. I trained with all of them. We were always joking and horsing around, but not this time. Just the rattle of the shuttle. And that heavy breathing. Everyone was thinking the same thing. We're off to fight alien invaders. Aliens. Think about that. We all grew up wondering what was out there. If we were alone in the universe, now we knew. We weren't alone. And we were in trouble. So there we were. About to face an enemy as different and unknown as we could imagine. I knew I had to say something, keep the men relaxed. So I turned to the soldier beside me, Hendrix, I think, and asked him how his mother was doing. Fine, he said. Why? Because I heard your mama's so ugly the Marines thought she was a Turian. Almost shot her. I got a few smiles. Then Hendrix turned to me and said, "Hell, Anderson, I heard it was a picture of your mama that started this goddamn war in the first place. Scared the Turians shitless." Everyone had a good laugh at that. And the boys fought great that night. Sometimes that's all it takes. A joke, a pat on the back. Just a little reminder that everything's gonna be okay. So, Tombstone data. Admiral David Edward Anderson. Not sure why anybody would be interested, but thanks for asking. I was born in London, June 8th, 2137. The last of three children born to Ursula and Paul Anderson. A nurse and a flight mechanic, respectively. But that's a little dry. Someone's gonna spice this up, right? Never been much for the spotlight. Anyway, where was I? It was a second marriage for my parents. They were almost 50 by the time they had me. My mother worked shifts, so my father would often take me to the base. While he worked, I watched transport ships and fighters take off. Worked his whole life around space travel, my father. But he never left Earth. Not for a day. He was a good man. But that's just a side note. Don't put that in. Who is it, Kaylee? Yes, I need to take that. I hope this is what you're after. I'll get to the more interesting N7 stuff next time. The Turians? Well, I might not always see eye to eye with the politics and the individual. But I have a great respect for the Turian military. Any Alliance soldier lucky enough to take part in their training programs will certainly be better for it. Their precision, skill, and discipline come together in a way that's second to none. Not that I'm faulting our own people or training. It's just that after fighting Turians in the First Contact War, years later, I had the opportunity to observe and train on Palavin. It was a turning point for me. And I would encourage any soldier to try it. It's a unique experience to put yourself in the squad of a Turian commander. My commander was an uncompromising bastard named Bartix Oryx. If you can find him, just ask how the platoon I commanded was trounced in his strategy game. Humbly. But I've used what I learned that day many times. The xenophobes will have their say. But I think it's vital that we do more of this kind of cross-species training. There you go. And if you do find General Oryx, let me know. I owe him money. You asked me to talk about the SSV Normandy. The Normandy SR-1. As commander of the Tokyo, I was consulted on the Normandy's design, and on board for her initial training exercises. The average person probably doesn't know that the Normandy was a joint project with the Turians. Acting CO, Eli Zander, was no diplomat. She ran out of patience with Turian posturing and politicking during construction. The chief architect of the Drive Corps, Octavio Tatum, and his team of Turian engineers were in the CIC for final training exercises. Tempers flared when Xander pushed the limits of the stealth system, waiting to vent the IES well past what Tatum was comfortable with. I tried to calm the situation, but it still ended with the Turian scientist in shackles and a human Turian fistfight at Korra's den later. Funny now, when I first laid eyes on the Normandy, she was the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen. Day after that training run, Admiral Wright found me on the bridge. She's yours, he said. Can't trust her to Xander. Send me a list of crew from the Tokyo you'd like, and prep for your first mission. Short command, thanks to Saren. Still, insides of a long career.
Commander Shepard, your table is ready.
I knew about this place before it was cool.
Oh, shut up. Dinner booked 7 months in advance. Tonight is perfect. It will be.
Hey, Shepard, not bad, huh? The sushi place is serious, like French guy at the door serious. Only had to save the galaxy twice to get a table here. You seen the line outside? But here I am, drink in hand. Best pilot in the universe and a rock star.
Any news from the Normandy?
You know, maintenance stuff. It's hard knowing a bunch of strangers are poking around in my ship. I mean, your ship.
The best thing we can do right now is park her and let the techs do their work.
Yeah, you're right. Maybe an oil change, space tire rotation.
Right. Trust me, it'll do her some good.
Oh, I trust you. Not sure about those shifty aerospace engineers. Always stealing the silverware.
And it's not easy to hand the ship over to somebody else.
I just don't want anybody touching her but me. That sounded a little weird.
Not from you.
Ouch. So, Commander, your email said it was important. What's up?
My email? I'm here because I got a message from you.
The hell? I didn't send anything.
Commander! Excuse me. Sorry. Alliance business. Commander, this is urgent!
Oh, come on, we haven't even gotten the appetizers yet.
Commander Shepard, I'm Staff Analyst Maya Brooks. Alliance. Excuse me. Alliance Intelligence. There are people trying to kill you.
Yeah, I think she's aware of that.
No, I don't mean Cerberus and the Reapers. I mean other people. New people. It's... Someone is hacking your account. Comm channels, personal records. They're targeting you specifically.
Big mistake.
Oh man, there's the angry face.
From the top. What do you know?
Excuse me, you don't have a reservation.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight's performance is brought to you by random acts of violence.
Get down!
Man, I love show business. Spread out, boys. Find me Shepard.
Stay there. I'm coming. Joker.
Ow, my pancreas.
Hey! Damn it!
Got one, sir!
Find the crew. I'm going after her.
Find the crew. Got it. Hackett. Did you see that? Savior of the Citadel uses Brittle Bones guy as bait.
Good. Brooks, you got hit.
I know. I used Medigel. A lot of it. All of it, actually. And now everything is a little bit bouncy.
I think you used too much.
So, can I help with anything?
Alert CSEC. I'll look for a way out. Brooks, I see some sky cars across the gap. Maybe a landing pad.
I'm checking the area. Transportation, no. Food, no. Laundry. Ah! It's a sky car lot. Scission Motors.
Get a shuttle over there. I'll find a way across.
Okay, right.
Caution. This area is under active repair.
So, it turns out CSEC has the whole area locked down. It's gonna be a tiny bit tricky to get you a shuttle.
Keep at it, Brooks.
Also, stay off your comm. Well, except for me. It's hacked. That's probably how they found you.
Who are these guys?
I don't know. But they really don't seem to like you.
Yeah, I'm sensing that.
Security alert. CSEC has restricted all travel within this area.
What's going on?
Server's attacking. Oh my god!
Should reach you soon. Excuse me, who is this? You're on an unsecured channel, and you're putting Commander Shepard in danger. In danger? Who is this?
Hang on. Joker mentioned Staff Analyst Brooks, yes? That's her. Everybody play nice.
CSEC has issued a complete lockdown in the lower wards in response to an attack by an unidentified organization. No details are yet known on this alleged terrorist attack.
Things are a little dicey.
Wouldn't have it any other way.
Found a way across. It's locked down.
Right, because of the, lockdown. Can you get through?
I'll try to override it.
CSAC authorization required. Confirming.
some kind of alarm? What's going on?
I thought I'd make things more interesting.
Of course you did.
Yeah.
Understood.
Okay. Brooks over. No, out. Brooks out. Oh, over and out. Brooks. Oh, damn it.
Having a bad day, Shepard?
You could say that.
Landing pad is over there, but it's behind a locked gate.
Let's look for a control panel.
I like your outfit. Control panel, right. I heard you fell through a fish tank.
We'll talk about it later.
A shame. I quite liked that restaurant.
We'll talk about it later. Stand back.
One moment. Hello.
Could you please open the gate? Thank you.
Please leave.
Well, I could have done that.
Just butting heads with the council over Krogan expansion. Shepard! We got a way out of here!
Rex, I'm a professional.
It's not a yes.
It's not a no.
Joker, we lost our ride. Where are you?
On my way. Picked up Brooks. Figured you'd have a few questions.
Good call.
Great place to fight it. Lots to destroy.
approaching your position, Commander. Just following the gunfire.
Copy that.
Sorry I'm late. Had to take the scenic route.
Scenic route? We nearly crashed 4 times. Where the hell did you learn to drive?
And Brooks says hi.
Let's go!
Get to the shuttle.
As you wish.
Someone want to tell me what's going on here?
Who were those mercenaries? They were heavily armed and using C-Sec shuttles.
I don't know. I've never seen them before.
I can't believe you survived all that. They had guns. And grenades. And those drone things.
It's all right. I'm calling Commander Bailey. See what's going on with C-Sec.
Okay, that sounds... Wait! Wouldn't that just make whoever you contact a target too?
She's right, Shepard. Until we know more, it's a huge risk.
Okay. For now, we run this ourselves.
Right. Ourselves. On our own. Outside the law. Okay. Yeah.
Brooks, gunfire means something serious is going on. Can you keep it together long enough for us to figure this out?
They said the medigel might make me jumpy. Also, the fact that I work a desk job and have never been shot before.
How did you get mixed up in this?
I monitored data for Alliance Intel to prevent fraud and hacking of officer IDs. Like, someone using an Admiral's pass to get into a nightclub on the Citadel when that Admiral is fighting on Tuchanka. I wrote a tracking program. It's really neat. I named it Mr. Biscuits, after my cat.
Brooks.
Right, sorry. Anyway, my program detected a breach in your classified files. Soon, everything we had on you was compromised. Personnel files, mission reports, everything.
Since when does hacking personnel records involve heavy weapon fire?
Think of what criminals could do if they had Shepard's military access codes. Or Spectre codes, even.
Explains why they need you dead, Shepard. Nothing to stop them till the damage is done.
Guess we're back on the clock.
We'll find a quiet evening. Just the two of us, when this is done.
Okay. Ideas on where to start with these guys?
Maybe. That pistol you picked up...
For such a tiny thing, it packs a punch. Never seen anything like it before.
Nor have I. Let me see if I can dig something up.
Well, you can try, but I should warn you, I haven't found anything yet, and I've been digging pretty deep.
I'm sure you have. Glyph.
Collating relevant intel for review, Dr. Tassoni.
Thanks.
All right, Liara's on point. What about the rest of the crew?
Yeah, what about those slackers?
Joker, you've been busy.
I found some folks who actually like being shot at.
Permission to come aboard, Shepard.